So, I'm from Wisconsin, and if this is the U.S., New York, L.A., Wisconsin's up here. We affectionately call it Bum F Nowhere. Now, I'm not going to swear in this. I promise my grandma I'm not going to swear. I'm also, disclaimer, I'm going to keep this pretty PG, so maybe this one F-bomb or one C-bomb. And I'm going to take the high road and not do any cheap Chinese jokes. But in saying that, and this is ruined because I walked out of here and I saw three Asian people and I was like, Mom? And my mom's right here, guys, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause. Mom, I'm gonna do one Asian mom joke. And I'm gonna save it to the end. It's one that you've heard before, okay? It's based on a true story. All right, Wisconsin. There's not much out there. There's our number one export is cheese, so if I tell a lot of cheesy jokes, I'm sorry. We're also right next to Canada, so we're a bit Canadian, so we're gonna apologize a lot. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. But we're not as bad as Canadians, because, you know, if you bump into a Canadian, you're like, oh, I'm sorry about that. I'm sorry that I'm breathing your air, too. I'm sorry, I can't do a Canadian accent. Now, Green Bay Packers is from there as well. So you guys don't know what it is. It's very conducive for creativity because it's really, like, there's nothing out there. There's a lot of flat lands, and there's, like, Indian Barrow Mounds, which has dubious history. But when it snows, snow goes yay high, we get cardboard boxes, and we sled down them, like, whee! Yeah, there's not much out there, honestly. In Dogma, Ben Affleck and Matt Damon are angels, and there's no space in heaven or hell, so they chucked them in Wisconsin. Now, I'm an Asian American actor in Australia. I also chauffeur, I also do comedy sometimes. But that's such a weird thing, isn't it? Like, okay, first off, I'm that Asian guy on Australian TV. You might have famous enough that you know my face, but you don't know my name. Unlike our friend Nikki Osborne. Woo! Stay to the end, she's really good. I'm that guy, I'm Neighbors. I did Neighbors for 2 years. I was a bartender for there. My name was Tim. You never hear my name in it. I did Hamish and Andy. I'm the man in the black tie. I worked with Jean-Claude Van Damme, his 10th commercial ever, as T-Hug. Thug. Number two. My current claim to fame is I played in Underbelly. Underbelly Chopper. And I played Russian Roulette with Chopper Reed. Don't ask me who wins. My first claim to fame is 9 years ago, I played in the Melbourne Annual Passion Play and I played Jesus Christ. So I'm the first Asian Jesus. Hey, I'm a celebrity. Fun fact, Jesus died at 33. I'm now 33, so my goal this year is to not get crucified. True story. All right, I'm Asian, American, Australian. What does that mean? I'm just as confused as you are, all right? So, I'm Asian, but I can't do math. I play interesting parts like Asian hipsters. Have you ever seen an Asian hipster?
Nah.
Neither have I. Not only can I not do math, but I can park. Yeah. All right. But I'm American as well, which means it's a funny thing. I love Trump. And I think he's hilarious, all right? Like, yeah, we should support reinforcing the borders. Yeah, keep those Asians out. That's why I'm here. I don't own a gun, so it's an interesting thing. And then I'm also Australian. G'day, how you going, Kaba? And when an Aussie meets me, they're like, they hear my voice, say, oh, you're American. And I'm like, yeah, well, give it away. Was it my hat? They're like, when did you arrive? I go, 14 years ago. 2 years in, I became a citizen, and I never got my wattle tree, though. I'm still sad about that. Mom, true story. All right, one thing I didn't get as an Asian, though, was the ability to haggle. Now, my mom is amazing at this. I still can't believe she's here. She surprised me without an invitation. Like, this is an Asian thing, and I love you for it. I love my mom to death, all right? And then, we're like eight Western Asians, and an Asian family is kind of like the Vulcans, like Spock. Like, it's a lot of like logic and a little bit of emotion, so I love my mom. All right, so I can't haggle, but my mom, when she goes to a night market, she goes in there, she sees an item that's worth $400, she goes, I want it for $40. The shopkeeper is like, no. She walks away. The guy's like, wait. Okay, 40. I'm like, how did you do that, Mom? So I try the same thing, right? I'm like, excuse me, sir. Slows down. He goes like, oh, this guy's a Western Asian guy. He speaks really good English. This guy's from a rich family. It's $4,000. Crap. But I'll tell you right. The cheapest thing, I love you, Mom. I'm going to share the story. The cheapest thing I've ever seen my mom do, me and my dad were in Malaysia, we're getting our foot massage. My mom comes from around the corner from a convenience store. She's like, what's Nick's number? Nick, my older brother in New York. What's Nick's number? We need to get his ID so we can get all these tissue boxes for very cheap. I'm like, Mom, the international phone call is going to cost more than those tissues. This is dedicated to my mom. Thank you so much. Guys, you've been a great audience. Love you all.